Hi everyone, today I am discussing about the lipid profile test. Well, the lipid profile test detects various parameters, for example, your total cholesterol, your triglycerides, your HDL, LDL, VLDL, and the ratios of these. These are tests by which you can know imbalances in your lipids. If left untreated or poorly managed, then it can lead to cardiovascular diseases, stroke, paralysis, clots, atherosclerosis. The first parameter is the non-HDL cholesterol. Your non-HDL cholesterol is your total cholesterol minus your HDL cholesterol. The normal values should be less than 130 mg per deciliter. The higher the values, that means you have more amount of bad cholesterol. Now, before you take cholesterol as a culprit, let me tell you that you do need cholesterol, because cholesterol is a precursor for different steroid hormones like aldosterone, testosterone, estrogen, cortisol. The second parameter is your total cholesterol. It should be less than 200 mg per deciliter. Now, please note that we do need cholesterol, as I explained, for different steroid hormones, at the same time for vitamin D synthesis. But too much of cholesterol can cause thickening of the walls of the arteries. Now just imagine that this is your artery, okay? So when there is too much buildup of cholesterol or plaque, it fills in this gap and makes it narrower, okay? Blocked arteries means atherosclerosis, and it can increase your risk of stroke, cardiovascular diseases. The third parameter is triglycerides. Its normal range should be less than 150 mg per deciliter. Now this is stored fat in your body. Its levels rise in blood after a meal. As your body converts the energy that it does not need right away into triglycerides. VLDL, very low density lipoprotein. Its normal range should be less than 30 mg per deciliter. Your liver makes VLDL, and the VLDL particles carry the triglycerides to your tissues. VLDL is also known as the bad cholesterol. It contributes to the buildup of plaque within your arteries, which I explained earlier. This is known as atherosclerosis. Fifth parameter is your LDL, that is your low density lipoprotein. Its normal range being less than 100 mg per deciliter. It is also known as bad cholesterol or atherogenic cholesterol, because high ranges of this can cause atherosclerosis and can increase your risk of cardiovascular diseases. Now I would like to bring your attention to the most important factor in this entire report, that is your lipid ratio. Lipid ratio just compares the amount of bad cholesterol to good cholesterol in your body. Well, ideally in a healthy person, the good lipids should be higher than the amount of bad lipids. These ratios are a better predictor of heart disease and the risk involved compared to the individual or isolated parameters themselves. First one is the total cholesterol to the HDL ratio. This is also known as the atherogenic index, because this gives you the risk of atherosclerosis. The higher the ratio, the higher the risk of heart diseases. The ideal ratio is less than 3 for women and less than 4 for men. Say a normal of less than 3.3. This ratio is a more specific and sensitive index of cardiovascular diseases than the total cholesterol. So when you look at your lipid profile, I want you to focus a little more on these ratios rather than just look at your total cholesterol. The second is your LDL to HDL ratio. In simple terms, the ratio of your bad cholesterol to good cholesterol. So ideally, the amount of your bad cholesterol should be lesser and the amount of your good cholesterol should be higher. Ideally, this ratio should be less than 2 for women and less than 3 for men. Somewhere between 0.5 to 3 is the normal range. Well, the good news here is that you can manage your cholesterol levels through diet and lifestyle. An active lifestyle and a healthy diet that is rich in fibers, that is rich in good fats, can help you reduce your bad cholesterol levels. Include a good amount of fiber in your diet. This will help you reduce your cholesterol levels. A sedentary lifestyle can increase your risk of cardiovascular diseases. So see that you have an active lifestyle. Include at least moderate intensity workout, say 150 minutes a week. This is the bare minimum that you can do, isn't it? If you're overweight or obese, that means the amount of bad cholesterol in your body is way higher than the amount of good cholesterol. So see that you focus on your weight reduction. What I mean is fat reduction. processed foods, sugar, deep fried foods, red meat, tinned or canned meat, that is processed meat, as well as dairy products. These can increase your risk of having more numbers of bad cholesterol. Bad lifestyle, too much of stress level, smoking, drinking, not sleeping on time, these can further aggravate the risk. Deep fried food, fast foods, these are very high in fats. These can further increase the risk of heart diseases. If you are looking for a diet to help reduce your bad cholesterol levels and improve your good cholesterol levels, kindly get in touch with me. If you found this useful or there are some particular topics that you want me to speak on, then please let me know in the comments below. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.